Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. Thank you so much for like, share and subscribe to my channel. If you are new visitor, definitely go to our channel and see all the videos. If you like those videos, click the subscribe button and also click the bell button so that you will get the notification. Okay, without wasting time, let's go to the topic. In this video, we will discuss how to create login system in MVC 5 application using session. Here, we will discuss four important points. First one is how to create this login form in MVC with required validations. Okay. Second, after entering this username and password, if user click on this login button, if the entered username and password are valid, we will show the dashboard to the user. If not valid, we will show the error message. Also, we will discuss how to save your save and retrieve logged in user details. Okay. Finally, we'll implement logout. Okay. This is the final output of this tutorial. Without entering username and password, if I click on this login button, it will show the error message. This field is required like that. If I enter valid username and password, click on this login button, it will go to the dashboard. See here we are displaying the username. Okay, here we have implemented logout. If I click on this logout, here we are redirect to login page. Okay, apart from this, we will discuss how to block and retrieve, authorize request into our application and user timeout configuration. Okay, yeah, in this video we will use a session management. Instead of this session management, we may implement user authentication, Windows authentication, latest ASP.NET identity, OWIN authentication, like that. I choose session management because of its simplicity, so that beginners can understand easily. Okay, I will explain you each step by step which I followed. If you have any doubts or any queries, so please leave your comments in the comment box below. Let's start. In Visual Studio 2013, first we will create new project. You can click the new project here, or else you can go to the file menu and select web under Visual C Sharp, then select ASP.NET web application, then name your application here. MVC login. Then select the location where you want to save this application. Then click on OK. Select empty template and then check this MVC checkbox. It has some predefined controls and views. Okay. Let's click on this OK button. Here we have route config in abstract folder and a web config and its related files. In route config, this is the URL format. Okay, our application must start with controller, then action, then followed by optional parameter ID. This is the default URL. Here home is the controller. Okay, and action index is the action method. Here ID is the optional parameter. Here we don't have any controller in this folder, so we have to create it. Before that, let's create database for this application. Database design can be done with Visual Studio itself. To create new database, right click on data connection, then click on create new SQL Server database. Here click dot of it's a local instance connection for me dots. Then here login db, this is our database name, then click OK. Here we have created our new database login db. Okay, now we have to add tables in under this tables folder. So right click on tables, add new table. See here in this table we have ID column as default. This is the primary key for this table, so I want to modify this as user ID. It's of the type integer. Then user name, it's of the data type varchar 50. Then password varchar 50. Now I want to set this user ID column as the identity key column for this table. Okay, let's go to this properties here. Identity specification, set this is identity to true. Okay, now change this table name as user. Okay, now we have to update this database. So click update here. So it's preparing update script for database. Okay, here we have created only one table, user. Okay, let's click on update database. See, our database updated successfully. Okay, now I want to insert some test data inside this table. So right click here, show table data. Inside this we don't have any record now. Yeah, retrieval username password pass at 123. Okay, we don't need to pass the user ID because it's identity column, so it will start with one and it will increment by one for every new record insertion. This increment operation will take care of this SQL server itself. Okay, save this. Now we have to create ADO.NET entity model for this database. Let's close all this. Okay, go to models folder, right click here, click on add, then click on ADO.NET entity data model. Here our model name will be DB model, then click on OK. Here select EF designer from database, then click on next. Here if you are using username and password for SQL server connection, you can use the second option, otherwise you can use the first option. Here after creating ADO.NET entity model, there will be a class with this name, so we will be using an object of this class to interact with this database. So I want to rename this class name DB models, then click on next. Here select the entity framework version. So here by default the entity framework 6 is selected, so I will use that, then click on next. In this window we have to choose our database objects that we want to add it in our ADO.NET entity model. In this table we have only one table, user, that's why I selected tables, then click on finish. This is how the entity model table looks like. This is the diagrammatic representation of our entity model user table. Okay, let's go back to Solution Explorer here. Inside this models folder, we have DB models. Inside this, we have user class, which is auto-generated. Okay, here it has the properties which is respective to our database table, user table, user ID, username, password, like this. So I will use this user class as model for this user table. Okay, now let's create a controller. Before that, you can see the here we have one more class, dbmodel.context.cs file. Inside this you can see this class DB models, which I told you this will be using an we will be using an object of this class to interact with this database. Okay, now let's create a controller. So right click on controllers folder, then click on controller. Here select MVC 5 controller empty, then click on add. So here our controller name will be login, then click on add. Here we have the login controller. Inside this login controller we have index action method. By default it's a get method. I want to make this login controller as default controllers. Go to app start folder, open route config. See here default controller is home, so replace this with login. Okay, now go back to login controller. Here let's create view for this index method. So right click, add view. Here keep view name and template as it is. I don't want to use your layout page, then click on add. Okay, here we have created index view. In MVC view we will use model class or view model class. In this case we will use this user class as the model. Okay, copy this namespace and go to here. Here declare our model. space, the namespace here, our model will be user. Okay. In this view layout null, this view is not a layout page, that's why I keep view layout as a null. This is not a partial view. Okay, it's a complete view. This line defines it's a document type HTML. This view starts with HTML tag and then head tag. And then meta tag defined for viewport, okay, and then we have title index. So I want to change this title name as login. Inside this body tag we will create login form. So here div with id login div. In MVC Razor, we can create form using statement and begin form method. So it will be like this at using. So here HTML dot begin form. Inside this begin form, we have to pass the post URL as a parameter. So first will be the action name. Authorize that we have to create, and the controller name will be login controller. That means we have to create this action method inside this login controller. Then form method will be post. Okay, that's it. Inside this using statement, for proper alignment I will use table element table. It contains two columns, first row. Inside this first row, first table details will be empty, second. So here login, I will add style for this text decoration. Here I will use underline. Okay, second row. Inside this second row, we will use td element. Here we will use the html.label for class to display label. Here model such that model.user username. Okay. In second, here we will display the text box. For that we will use editor for helper class. Here model such that model dot username. Okay, like this we have to create one more row for password. So copying this and pasting below that, here instead of this username, replace the username with password. Okay. Apart from this, we need one more row to add buttons. So first element empty, second. Here we will use input tag as a type. It will be submit, and then value will be login. Okay, copy this and pasting below that. Your type will be reset, and then name same. We don't want this name attribute, let's remove it. Value will be clear. Okay, now we can run this application to see how it looks. To run this application without debug mode, you can use the shortcut Control plus F5. This login form is ready now. This login form looks like this. Okay, I want to change the position of this login page as center, and I will give border to this login form. For that, go to index view. Here in head tag, so I will add script tag. Sorry, instead not script, style tag. So inside this style tag, I will add some predefined style for this ID login div. Okay, let's paste it, save this and reload the page. Okay, it works fine. Okay, now it's in center of our screen. Okay, see, username and password labels are created using this label for helper class. Okay, I need space between user and name. Okay, for that, go to user class here. Here I will use attribute display name. Okay, we have to add namespace system.component model. So here within double quote user with space and then name. Okay, now build the solution. To build the solution, you can use the shortcut Control Shift B. Okay, now reload the page. Now you can see here we have the space between user and name. Okay, now check the password text box. Enter some text. Okay, see here, it shows the enter character as it is. Normally, password text box will not show the exact text. Instead, it will show the dots or any symbols. Okay, for that, we can add your in user class. We will add data type. So, we have to add namespace for this attribute. Component model.data annotations. Here inside data type dot password. Okay, again build the solution and reload the page. Okay, if now enter some text in password text box, it shows the dot symbol. Okay, now it works fine. See here in index view, in begin form function, we passed this post URL. So inspect element, right click inspect. See a form action in login controller, we are authorize method. So far we didn't create this method, so we have to create now. So go back to login controller. Here we'll create this action method, public action result. Authorize return view. By default, all actions will be a get method. As I told you, in index view, we passed this authorize in login controller as a post method. So we need this action method as a post action method. So for this, we will add this HTTP post method by using this HTTP post attribute. Okay. Okay, in browser. Reload the page. If a user enters a username and a password, then click on this login button. It will post this form into this post method, authorize method. Okay, now let's add validations to this login form. Here username and a password are mandatory field for this login form. Okay, for that go back to user class. Here we will add required attribute for both the fields. Okay, here required error message equal to, here within double quote we can mention the error message, this field is required. Okay, copy this line. This is same for password also, pasting below that. Okay, now save this. Okay, this error message will be shown below this username and text box. Okay, go back to index view here. We need to create one more row. Here, first td element empty, second td element. Here we will show the error message at html dot your validation message for using this helper class. We will show the error message model such that model dot username. Okay, copy this row. And pasting below that. This is also same for password. Also replace this username with password. Okay, guys, this is a client side validation, so we need to add some scripts file. So before that, we have to add. So right click on project here, manage NuGet packages. Yeah, jQuery validation. Here we need to install this jQuery unobstructed validation. Install, click I accept. It installed successfully. Using this plugin where we can validate. Okay, now you can see the scripts folder. Now we have the script file here. Okay, now we have to add this here. Drag this jQuery 1.8.0 min script file. Then below that, we need to add this jQuery validate.min.js. Finally, we will use this jQuery validate unobstructed.min.js. Okay, now build the solution using shortcut. Okay, now reload the page. Here, without entering this username and password, click on this login button. Let's check what will happen. Okay, click. Wow, it's showing the error message. This field is required. Okay, now I want to add some CSS style to display this error message as red color. Okay, right click here, inspect. Okay, here expand C, here class field validation error. So we will use this field validation error to show the error message as red color. Go back to index view. Here paste the class name. Inside this, I will mention the color red. Okay, now save this and reload the page. Okay, now click on this login button without entering these two datas. Okay, now it works fine. Now the error message is displayed in red color. Okay, here enter some username and a password. It will post this form into authorize post action method in login controller. Okay, here first we will add the namespace to access this class. Okay, because we are posting this username and the password data to this user model class, so here we will use the class user object name user. So this username and the password will be binded to this user class object user. In this post action method, first we will check the username and password already exist or not. Okay, for that we will use this using statement. Using statement here, db models, we will create object db equal to new db models. Okay, here we will declare one variable user detail equal to db.users.where your x such that x dot username equals this entered username from this user object username and x dot password equals user dot password. Okay, then first our default. Okay, if the username and the password already exist, the particular user row will be that in this variable user data. Okay, if not exist, this variable will be null. Okay, we will write the condition. If this variable user detail equals null, means we have to show the error message in login form. For that we need to add one more property in user class. Here in property it's of the type string. Your variable name will be property name will be login error message. So we will use this property here in login controller. If user detail equals null, means we will display this user dot login error message equal invalid, or you can write any message here, a wrong password or anything, invalid username or password. We need to send this updated model to our login form. For that, return view. So your action name index, then we will send the return updated model, this model. Okay, now we want to show the login error message inside our login form before this submit button. Okay, so go back to index view. Here before this submit button, here we will create one more row. Inside this row td, here I will use call span, it will be 2. Okay, here we will use label in label. I will use the class field validation error, so it will display the error message in red color. Okay, now here at html dot, here we will use the helper class display for your model such that model dot login error message. Okay, that's it. Save this and reload. See here in our table, username and password, this like this, virtual and password 123. Okay, in browser, if I enter wrong username and password, then click on this login button. So it's showing the error message, invalid username and password. Okay, it works fine. Okay, now go back to login controller. Here what we wrote, if user detail, that username and password are not valid, so we are displaying the error message. Okay, but in case if the username and password are valid, so we will do like this, else. Here we will save the user ID in session. So your user ID equal to user dot user ID. Okay, After successful login, we need to show the dashboard to the user. For that, we have to create one more controller. Okay, right click on controllers folder, add controller. So select MVC file controller, then click on add. Your controller name will be home controller, then click on add. Okay, here we have the home controller. Okay, so let's create view for this index method. Add view, keep view name template as it is. We are not use this view as a layout page, then click on add. Okay, keep as it is. Inside body tag, I will add h1 tag. So here dashboard. Okay, after successful login, we will redirect to this dashboard. Okay, for that, in login controller, yeah, we will write return redirect to action. Here first action name index, then controller name home controller. Okay, this not required, let's remove it. Okay, let me run this application. Okay, now enter valid username, which will password pass 123, then click on this login button. So it will redirect to dashboard page. Okay, let me close this tab and exit from IIS Express. Right click, exit. Okay, let's run this application again. See here, now we are in login page. Okay, if I enter URL like this, instead of this login controller, I enter home controller. Let's press enter. Now we can go to dashboard without login. Okay, we want to block unauthorized request. For that, your index view, your layout null. Okay, here if session, your user ID, this name should exact match with this name, session user ID. Okay, session user ID equals null. Your user ID equals null means user is not in logged in. In this case, we will send response to our login page. For that, response dot redirect. Here we are redirecting to login page within double quote till symbol followed by forward slash, then controller name login, action name index. Okay, now save this, run the application, reload. Okay, let me try this URL now. Instead of this login, change this to home controller, then press enter. So it's redirect to login page itself. So in this way, we can block unauthorized request into our application. If there might be a lot of use in our application, it's not a good method or good approach to copy these lines and pasting in all views to check whether the user logged in or not. Instead of that, we can use a layout. In almost all pages, there might be a layout page. Here we are not using layout page. Okay, in such case, so we can move this code into that layout page so that we can reduce the redundancy in code. There are some websites, if you logged in, you are not using this site 60 minutes above. After that, if you reload that page, you have to re-log in the site again. Okay, the same case will happen in our case also because of session timed out in our case. So we will talk about the session timeout in our later video, but in this video I will tell you the bit. In our case, normally session timeout is 30 minutes. If user login to our site is in dashboard and is in idle for 30 minutes and above, if we try to reload the page, it will be redirected to login page, because after 30 minutes, this session will be expired. That means the session is not valid. This session user ID will be a null. Okay. If you see, basically session is created for user, that makes a separate session is created for each logged in user. If user logged in from India, there will be a separate session. If another user logged in from UK, there will be a separate session. Okay, basically session will be valid only by default. Session will be valid only 30 minutes. Okay, after that session will expire. In that case, user need to re-login into the application. Okay, if you want to change the session timeout, you can do that in web config file. So go to web config. In web config, you can see this session state timeout 30. Here you can change this timeout 30 to 20 or 60 minutes as depends upon you. Okay, now it's the time to implement logout part. Okay, for that go to login controller. Here I'm going to create one more action method, public action result method name logout. Inside logout we will abandon session. Okay, session dot abandon. This abandon method will clear all the session variables, like a session user ID will be reset to null. Okay, after that we will return redirect to index action method index in login controller. Okay, now let me add button or link for logout in dashboard view. So go back to index in home controller. Here I will add h anchor tag, here href, instead here we will use at url dot action. Here first action name logout, second parameter controller name login, your anchor text will be logout. Okay, now build the solution and run this application. Here enter username and password, then click on login. So here we have the logout link in dashboard. Okay, here click on this logout, so it should redirect to this login page. Okay, now try to enter this home.index, so we can't go to dashboard without login, so it's redirect to login page. Okay, in login controller, see here, after successful login, we saved user ID in session. Like that, we can save other details of the user. Okay, if you want to save username, so we can do like this, copy this line and pasting below that. Here, instead of user ID, so I will use username. Here, replace this user ID with username. Now after successful login, we may need to track current user ID. okay, here logout, here int user ID equal to session user ID. So it's int type, so we are casting into int. Okay, now if you want to show the current username in dashboard, here in index view, here I will show the username in h3 tag, username here at session within double quote, use the same name, username. Okay, copy this name and pasting here. So it's varchar type, so we need to use this toString. Okay, now build the solution and run this app. Okay, enter username trail and pass at 123, then click on login. Okay, see here, here we have the username, current username. Okay guys, so far we have discussed all the related topics in login system. Hope you liked it. Do share this with all your friends. Also like and subscribe to this channel. Thank you so much for watching this video. See you there in next video. Bye bye.